Broadcasting for a worldwide audience.
You are listening to Radio Lewes, where the music matters, and welcome back to the Rock Show. And this week, we've got all new stuff. Slightly inspired by Cy, because he's introduced me to a few new bands recently, most notably Fu Manchu, Red Fang, and Crobot. And as he very kindly gave me the week off on Thursday, if you listen to the live show, you'll have heard Cy and Nick, it was a great show. I had some time on my hands, so I gave my music mole some time off as well, and I went looking for new music, and I found a whole show full. I don't know any of these bands, I know nothing about them, so we're going to learn about them together. You may have heard of them, I didn't. We're going to start with a band from California, I think. Orange County, indeed. They're a Atreyu metalcore band. Been around since 1998. And this is the title track to their 2018 album, In Our Wake. I don't normally go for metalcore, but I like that. They've been around since 98, originally named Retribution. They changed their name to Atreyu after the character of the same name from Michael Ende's book, The Neverending Story. The name change came because of a change of members and progressive musical styling. They've had seven albums to date, and that, like I said, came from the most recent one, In Our Wake. I'm going to be looking for a bit more of their stuff. I like that very much indeed. Next on the list is a band called Black Briar, and I'll tell you about them after this. I'd Rather Burn. ¶¶ Oh, a beautiful track from Blackbriar. They're a gothic rock alternative metal band hailing from the Netherlands. They've released 2 EPs, 5 singles and 4 official music videos and 3 acoustic live videos, and performed alongside bands like Epica and Mayan. They've been active since 2012, so they haven't been that busy musically. But that track comes from their most current EP, and it's called We'd Rather Burn, from last year, October in fact. Again, another great find, I think. A band called Dream Theatre are up next with Untethered Angel. Another great sound, and another band who's had a bit of a name change. Between 1985 and 1998, they were called Majesty. They were formed by John Pellucci, John Mayung, and Mike Portnoy. And they're a progressive metal band from the States. And that came from their brand new album, Distance Over Time. And on the back of that, I'm definitely going to look for that album. This next act probably could have made it into the Silly Name Show. This is Novelists. The Light, the Fire. What a sound. You might be interested to know this might be a first for Radio Lewes, because this might be the first time I've ever played a French band on the rock show. They were founded in Paris in 2013, and they've got a respectable discography. A demo EP, which was self-published in 2014, followed by a single called Gravity, which again was self-published. And in 2015, an album called Souvenirs. And then that song, The Light, the Fire, was the lead single to the current album from 2017 called Noir. And if they carry on sounding like that, I'll play more of them. I hope they get a new album out very, very soon. Savage After Midnight is the band that comes next. 10 feet tall.
She says my name belongs in light, shining bright. She says my words to get her high, but nobody does it like you do. 12 shades of the color blue. A million people trying to be like you, but nobody does it like you do.
I said I didn't know anything about any of these bands, and this lot really deserves some airplay. They've had a tough time. That track, 10 Feet Tall, seems to be the lead single from their debut EP, which will be released in March, and it will be called 1159. It's coming on March the 8th. They've had a really tough time of it. I mean, it's hard enough for bands to break it out of their hometown club scene into the arena stage, but they've put up with fires at studios, loss of material, a lawsuit for something or other, I'm not going to go into that. And they've had to have a name change, a label change. All sorts of stuff has been going on with this band. They've been a band since 2009, and they're only just getting their debut out. I think they need to be commended. And dogged perseverance and unyielding determination? Definitely. Definitely. I look forward to more from them. Scorpion Child is next. Polygon of Eyes.
Oh,
There you go, Scorpion Child. Formed in 2006, they're from Austin, Texas. And that was from their 2013 self-titled EP, I believe. Let me have a quick look at the discography. No, it's their first album, their debut album. I apologise for that. Their debut EP was The Southern Sting. Acid Roulette from 2016 is their second album, and let's hope they've got some new stuff coming up, because I really like the sound of those. I will be trying to get hold of both of those albums. Next band on the list is Seven Dust and Dirty. Miss that band, they're brilliant. They've been around since 1994, then a couple of name changes, but they've done exceptionally well. They've had several records go gold certified, and they've had 12 albums to date. That song comes from All I See Is War from last year, and again, it's another one I think I'm going to have to look for. You're listening to The Rock Show on Radio Lewes, where the music matters, and this is all about new stuff. So let's have some more. This is Skindred and Kill the Power.
Everybody dress back.
Kindred there from Newport in Wales. Been around since 1998 and they're a heavy metal band that mixes heavy metal, alternative rock and reggae. What a sound that was. That was from 2013, so not particularly new, but it is new to the show. From the album Kill the Power from 2014. Their latest album, however, is Big Tings from last year. And again, I think I might have to go looking for some. Another one I haven't heard of at all, mind you, that goes the same for all these bands. This is Star Set and Bring It Down version 2.0.
Bring it down.
Start it? Let me put my teeth in and start again. Starset is an American rock band from Columbus, Ohio, in the United States, formed by Dustin Bates in 2013. Their debut album, Transmissions, came in 2014, and the album that track comes from, Vessels, the second album, was released on January the 20th, 2017. And they are a very savvy band. They've expanded their success with the use of social media and YouTube and various others. And against the tide, they are actually making financial success as well as musical success. So I wish them all the best. It's a great sound. And they're another one that are going to be added to my list. Another band that really piqued my interest when I heard this. Within Temptation, they're called, and this is Supernova.
We'll be right back.
Within Temptation are a Dutch symphonic metal band formed in 1996. Although they do get often called a gothic metal band because of their first album, which was called Enter, which was a mostly gothic sound, maybe with a hint of doom metal in there as well. But their sound is slightly different on every album, and they much prefer the symphonic metal label. And that album, that song comes from the album Resist from this year, their brand new one. And they've got quite a respectable discography. There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 albums and 5 live albums and DVDs. So they've been doing well. And I'm going to look for that Resist. I really like that. Now, I did say I thought I hadn't heard of any of these bands. That wasn't quite true. The next one I have heard of, I just don't play them very much, if ever. It's Slipknot. But I heard this and I liked it. It's Psychosocial.
We're killing all the hate, was all we had. Who needs enough?
I don't normally go for Slipknot because I don't like all that angry shouting, but for some reason I like that one. They've been around a long time now, haven't they? 1995 they were founded. They've had a couple of hiatuses, and as of 2017 they've got a new album. That one came from All Hope Is Gone from 2008, which I think is the oldest song on today's list. What can I say? I like the sound of that, so I played it. Moving on to the Amity Affliction and Drag the Lake. Oh, I was really hoping I wouldn't have to put an explicit tag on this week. I'd forgotten about that one, so I apologise for that. But that was Amity Affliction, Drag the Lake. They're an Australian metalcore band from Glimpy in Queensland, formed in 2003. And that track comes from their latest album called Misery from last year. And besides the naughty language, it's not a bad sound for metalcore. Now that's it, I'm afraid. We're out of time. You've been listening to The Rock Show here on Radio Lewes, where the music matters, and this has been a show of new music, at least to the show. And I'm going to leave you with a band called Powerwolf, and I'm guessing they are Scandinavian, because I can't read the title of the song. I'm very sorry about that. I will type it up on the description, and you can try and translate it for yourself. Till next time. Bye-bye.
Local webcasting for a worldwide audience.